Namaskar, I'm Sanchita Roy. Welcome to class 12 biology class. Today I'm going to discuss the 10th chapter, Microbes in the Human Welfare, part 1. I have discussed about the microorganisms in my previous video in chapter 8. In chapter 8, we have seen that human health and diseases. Over there, we have seen how different types of microorganisms are responsible for causing different types of diseases in the human body. Now, in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the usefulness of the different types of microorganisms. Microorganisms are not only harmful to the human beings, but human beings are also dependent upon the microorganisms for the different types of food products, as well as we are dependent upon the microbes for cleaning the environment. So, over here, we can see that how these microorganisms like aspergillus, lactobacillus, saccharomyces are used to obtain different types of food products which are useful or on which we are dependent on an everyday basis. Over here, microbes are what we know in the previous chapter. We have seen microbes are of different kinds, like the protozoan, bacteria, fungi, and microscopic plant viruses, viroid, and also prions that are proteinaceous infectious agents. Basically, virus, viroid, and prions, what are they? They are pathogenic. We are not dependent. They are not. So far, no usefulness of these viruses could be seen. Basically, they are responsible for causing different types of diseases in plants and animals. They can also be found in deep inside the geysers, deep in soil, under the layer of the snow, and in highly acidic environments. Microbes are found in every type of environmental conditions. They can be grown in high temperatures, deep inside the soil. They can be seen in extreme cold temperature also, as well as in acidic environment. We have seen about the thermoacidophils over there, halophils, the different types of bacteria. Arch bacteria are classified on the basis of their growth. Microbes are so minute that they cannot be seen by the naked eyes. That is the reason they are known as microbes, because we need the help of the microscope to visualize them. Bacteria and fungi can be grown on nutritive medium to form colonies. So these bacteria and fungi can be easily grown in the laboratory medium. And when they are grown in large colonies, they can be seen in their naked eyes. As I have said, microbes are responsible for causing many diseases in the human beings, plants, and animals. But there are several microorganisms are useful to man in diverse ways. There are several types of bacteria. They can be good bacteria or the bad bacteria. The good bacteria are of different kinds, which are present in the whole body of the human beings, basically in the digestive system, which helps in the process of digestion. At the same time, when these bad bacteria enter inside the intestine or the stomach, what can they cause? They can cause different types of diseases. There are different bacteria in the mouth also, which helps in the process of digestion. Again, harmful bacteria which are causing the oral cavities. Okay, so there are bacteria which can remain in high acidic medium inside the body in the different parts of the body. So as I said, microorganisms are the useful organisms. Always they are not harmful. They can be used by the people or by the environment. In case of the people, to make food and medicines. We are dependent on the microorganisms for our food products and the medicines. And the ecosystem is helping, the microbes are helping the ecosystem in the recycling of the nutrients by the process called decomposing. The microorganisms are continuously working on the dead and decomposed organisms, and they are converting the nutrients present in the dead organisms into the nutrients. So the continuously the nutrient cycles are going on. We know the elements are present in the earth surface. They are utilized by the producers and they are transferred to all the groups of organisms. And again, they are returned back into the earth by the help of the decomposers, that is the microorganisms. So let us see the different uses of the microorganisms, how they are used by the human beings for our benefit. Microbes in the household products. How the microbes are used in the household products? First of all, we will be discussing. We can see that they are used for making curd, dough, toddy, cheese, etc. So we will discuss how the curd is made. Curd is first made by the lukewarm milk. Lukewarm milk is taken, and then what is there? That in that lukewarm milk, the lactobacillus is being added. A small amount of lactobacillus is added into the lukewarm milk. Then it is mixed, dissolved over here carefully, and it is allowed to settle down. And after some time, we can see the milk is getting converted into curd. So what is there? Curd is formed by adding bacteria such as lactobacillus and others, commonly called as lactic acid bacteria in milk. This lactic acid bacteria will convert the fresh milk protein into the more easily digestible protein. A small amount of curd is added to the fresh milk as starter, which makes millions of lactoacidic bacteria. Lab at suitable temperature multiply and convert milk into curd, which also improves the nutritional quality by increasing the vitamin B12. During growth, lab produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk proteins. Lab also checks disease-causing microbes in the stomach. So, what is actually happening? We need to take the lukewarm milk. We cannot use a hot milk. If we take the hot milk, what happens and dissolve the lactobacillus gets killed over here. At the same time, we cannot take the cold milk. If we take the cold milk, in that again, the lactobacillus cannot grow. So it is always advised to take the lukewarm milk. In the lukewarm milk, the lactobacillus can grow rapidly and convert the milk protein into the curd. While doing that, what happens? The lactobacillus increases the amount of vitamin B12 in the curd. At the same time, these acids also helps in the digestion of different other substances, as well as they help in causing the preventing the growth of the disease-causing microbes in the stomach. That is the reason consumption of the curd is very healthy. It is considered very healthy. Now, many people cannot digest milk, but they can digest curd because the stronger proteins which are present in the milk, which cannot be digested by the human beings, are already getting converted into simpler proteins by the lactobacillus. So the lactobacillus, this curd, so in the exam, what happens, what are the main areas of the question? Which type of microorganism is used to make curd? It is lactobacillus. They are called lactic acid bacteria because they are responsible for producing lactic acid. The next is why is the curd more improved than the milk? Because while the formation of the curd, when the milk is getting converted to curd, vitamin B12 gets increased in the curd by the action of the bacteria. What are the other useful of the lactobacillus? It helps in checking the disease-causing microbes in the stomach. When it goes into the stomach, it prevents the body from the harmful microbes. So many times we see that at the end of the main meal, we should consume the curd, because the curd helps in digesting the food, because it is containing acid, and acidic medium helps in the faster digestion of the proteinaceous part, which takes place in the stomach. So this acid is helping in the process of digestion, as well as because it is containing acidic medium, it helps in killing the different pathogens present in the body, in the, especially in the stomach, and helps us from different types of digestive diseases. The next is dough. In a regular basis, we are dependent upon the bread. So the bread is made by the help of the dough. Other than that, we make the batter of idli, dosa, in which again the microbes helps us in many ways. Dough is formed by the fermentation caused by the bacteria. How the process? The dough is made by used to make the bread is fermented using baker's yeast, that is a Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is the simplest type of yeast which we have seen, which we have read the structure of the yeast in our previous classes. So first, the yeast is dissolved with lukewarm water and the yeast is allowed to grow. Then this yeast water is then mixed with the flour. Over here, little bit of salt, little bit of sugar is added into it, and then this liquid of the yeast, the solution of the yeast and the lukewarm water, is added into the wheat, or that is a flour. And then they are mixed thoroughly. They are kneaded thoroughly. After kneading, it is allowed to keep for certain time by covering it. What is the reason? Why do we need to do this step? In this step, what is happening? The yeast will multiply in the dough, and these yeast will produce carbon dioxide during the process of respiration. And after some time, this dough is used to bake. We are putting it in the microwave or in the oven, and then it is allowed to bake. After some time, we can see that the bread is ready, and we see that inside the breads there are small holes like structure. Those holes are actually the place where the carbon dioxide are produced. The carbon dioxide produced by the yeast are removed by during the process of baking. So carbon dioxide released during the process of fermentation gives the fluffy appearance to the dough. Dough is also used to make the foods like idli, dosa, in addition to different types of breads. If you are able to see, if your mother's, while your mother is making the dough, the batter for making idli and dosa, if you see that she will not grind the paste and immediately make idli and dosa. We have to keep it for some time so that it will get fermented, and during the process of fermentation we will see it will become the quantity will get increased. Okay, when we keep it in the container, the quantity of the substance will become increased because of the fermentation of the bacteria, and that will help in making the idli or the dosa in a proper manner. So this is how the bacterias are useful bacteria like the Saccharomyces cerevisiae is utilized by human beings in a daily basis. The next is toddy. Toddy is a traditional drink of the southern India. It is made by the fermentation of the sap from the palm tree by bacteria. Number of other drinks or food are also made by fermentation. Over here you can see in the toddy plant, in the palm plant, they make a small incision and they tie a bottle or a container in with that part of the plant, and it is left it for us several hours. During this time, the sap of the plant gets collected into it, and as it gets collected, when it gets fermented, it transforms into alcohol, and which is being utilized by the common people as a type of drink. The next is the cheese. Cheese is made by the partial degradation of the milk using different microbes. These are the different ways the how the cheese is being the processed. The processing of the cheese, the milk is first taken and then it is added with some chemicals, and then what happens, it gets like this. Now this is left out over here. This is a cottage cheese, like we make the paneer, that is also a milk product, and the cheese are made for, they are kept for several months to develop a good quality of cheese. Swiss cheese is made by the bacteria Propionibacterium sarmani. The large holes in this cheese are due to the production of the large amount of carbon dioxide by the bacteria. The more the holes are, better the cheese are. Roquefort cheese is made by ripening with the fungi Penicillium roqueforti to obtain a specific flavor. Microbes are also used to ferment fish, soybean and bamboo shoots to make food. So these are the different ways how the cheese are made, and they are consumed by the human beings as a dietary. So cheese plays an important role, and it is a very tasty and a healthier food compound also. The next is the microbes in the industrial products. Different types of microbes are used by the different industries. Basically, in the fermented beverages, in the antibiotic productions, organic acids, alcohol, enzymes and bioactive molecules, for obtaining these different types of substances, microbes are used in the industrial purposes. Production of these products on the industrial basis needs growing microbes in the very large vessels called the fermenters. For growing them in the factories, we use the help of the take the help of the fermenters. First, we will discuss about the fermented beverages like the wine, beer, whiskey, brandy and rum. How they are obtained? They are obtained by the fermentation of the malted cereals and the fruit juices. Either we are taking malted cereals and the fruit juices, like from the rice also we can obtain the alcohol, as well as from the fruit juice. In this we use again the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is the yeast or the brewer's yeast, to produce the ethanol. When they undergo the process of anaerobic respiration, they are responsible to produce the ethanol as an excretory product. Variety of alcoholic drink depend on the type of the raw materials used and type of the processing. Wine and beer are produced without distillation. Whiskey, brandy and rum are produced by the distillation of the fermented broth. We will just get a glimpse of it, how it is. These are the different types of cereals. They are malted. They are either, first they are boiled in the hot water, and these grains, after that they are steamed, and after that steaming they can be stored, and from which the liquor can be developed. If we soak the steamed rice in water and we keep it for fermentation, then that rice pulp will develop, the cooked rice will develop into the alcoholic compounds. Okay, then the next is what, even the different types of the steaming, the other types of food grains like the wheat, the corns, they can also be used for the process of developing, for obtaining the different types of alcohols by the process of fermentation. The distilled grains are taken, they are cooled, and then they are put in the fermentation pit, and from the fermentation pit the grains are removed, and the sap, which is the remaining part, is steamed, and then fresh liquor is obtained from it. So these are the different ways how the liquor is produced in the factories. The comparison between whiskey and brandy. Whiskey is obtained from the cereals. By the help of the barley, we are obtaining the whiskey. Whereas brandy is obtained from the grapes. The grapes are fermented, the juice of the grapes are fermented, and then we are obtaining the brandy. Both they are used by saccharification, then fermentation. It is the grape juice are kept In that way only it undergoes fermentation and gradually it transforms into alcohol. Submersed fermentation is done over here also. Submersed pure culture of yeast is being done. Liquid state distillation, liquid state. So these are the comparison between the whiskey and the brandy, how they are produced. The next is the antibiotics. On a daily basis, we are dependent upon the antibiotics for different reasons. Whenever we come across with different types of infections, the doctor prescribes us different types of antibiotics. What are antibiotics? They are basically obtained from the either the bacteria or from the fungi, which helps us to protect ourselves from the disease-causing pathogens. So, antibiotics are chemical substances which are produced by some microbes and can kill or retard the growth of the other microbes. Penicillin was the first antibiotic discovered by Alexander Fleming. Alexander Fleming was the first to introduce or to produce to discover the penicillin. The penicillin is a antibiotic which is obtained from Penicillium notatum. This is an example of the penicillin. Okay, this is a colony of the penicillium. Over here, these are the conidia. We know these are the asexual reproductive organs. Fleming discovered penicillin. How did Fleming discover it? He discovered while working on Staphylococcus bacteria. In the cultured medium, he was growing them and he saw that due to some reason, this Staphylococcus was not able to grow. He observed a mold growing in one of his unwashed culture plates around which Staphylococci could not grow. He found out that it was due to the chemical produced by the mold, that is the penicillium. Penicillium notatum was growing in the same culture medium. And as the penicillium notatum, the mold started growing. What he observed that the Staphylococcus bacteria stopped growing. He named it the penicillin after the mold Penicillium notatum. Mold means the fungi. Okay. So after the name of Penicillium notatum, he gave the name of the antibiotic penicillin. Ernst Chain and Howard Florey discovered full potential of this antibiotic. Penicillin was extensively used during the World War II. Fleming, Chain and Florey were awarded Nobel Prize in the year 1945 for this discovery. In the World War II, penicillin was utilized massively in treating the war fighters. Antibiotics are used to cure deadly diseases such as plague, whooping cough, diphtheria, and leprosy. So, these are the uses of the antibiotics, and to produce them, there are large types of devices that are utilized in the factories. So the staphylococcal can help in curing all these different types of diseases. Okay, so in the next video, I will be continuing how the microbes are helpful in improving the quality of the ecosystem. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.